Hey guys, thanks for coming back for another video. Remember, if you like our videos, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, hit the little notification bell so that you're made aware of any videos that we release in the future. Today's video, I want to talk about the cost of general liability insurance for plumbing contractors. We get this question all the time. We insure lots of plumbers. It's one of our niches. We've been working with plumbing contractors for a long time. And I think something right off the bat that if you're researching this topic, whether you're starting a new plumbing contracting business or you've had the business for a while and you're looking at different options for general liability, be very careful about the policy forms and about the coverage, because the prices vary because the coverage varies. And what I mean by that is there are policies out there that you can choose to go with them if you know what you're buying. And there are policies out there, general liability policies, that sublimit or exclude water damage for plumbing contractors, if you can believe that or not. Our agency, we stay away from that type of coverage, right? We don't want to provide our clients with substandard policies, substandard coverage, because when the time comes for them to have a claim, we want to make sure they're protected, right? There's also a well-known carrier out there that limits or excludes coverage based on the size of the property that the plumbing contractor is working on. Residential 5,000 and above square feet, commercial 20,000 and above. Again, something that's really important to know if you're looking at your general liability options and not just focused on the premium, but also understanding what's in the policy, where the exclusions, where the limitations lie, what the coverage forms dictate. Because again, as I said it before, no two policies are the same. But now let's talk about the cost of general liability insurance for plumbing contractors. Now, lots of different factors come involved here, not just with the coverage itself, like I was talking about, and not just the limits. A lot of times people call and they say, well, you know, does the limit of insurance really? Well, not really. I mean, you know, $1 million is pretty standard for the occurrence limit, $2 million for the aggregate. Really doesn't cost a whole lot more to go from $1 million aggregate to $2 million aggregate. So all of our clients get $2 million. You know, it might cost another $50 a year. Well worth it. Products completed operations. Now, the second thing we need to talk about is the type of work that you're performing. Okay, that's going to heavily dictate the type of policy and the cost of your policy that you purchase. Why? Again, policy forms. One of the biggest is new residential construction. Okay, new residential construction is a higher risk for general liability companies than people that are specializing, or contractors, plumbing contractors that are specializing in service and repair and remodeling work. Why? Because more claims come against contractors that are involved in new residential versus remodeling and repair. Now, I'll take that a step further. How about new developments? For example, if you're a plumbing contractor and you get involved in new condominiums, new mixed-use buildings, new tract home developments, that's gonna have a heavier weight on the policy and the premium than if you don't. Carriers provide different forms on their policy. So for example, if you're a plumbing contractor and you do new multi-unit construction, okay, whether it's tracts or condos, look at your policy and make sure that the form allows you to work on those types of developments. You know, you're gonna see limitations for the number of units in condominium communities, the number of homes in tract communities. Even if you do custom homes, you'll see policy forms that dictate how many custom homes you can work on per year. All of that's gonna have a big impact on the cost of your policies. Pay attention to it, it's really important. No two policies are built the same, and carriers also have the availability to switch out policy forms. They could charge a premium for it, but they have the availability to make sure that you're protected based on the type of work you're doing. So remember, new residential, new multi-unit. Now, if you're talking about apartments, most carriers consider apartments commercial. Why? Because there's a single owner. Whereas when you're talking about new condominiums and new tract homes, there's multiple owners, there's HOAs, those types of entities tend to bring more claims against contractors involved in those developments than not. New commercial is not so much an issue. Carriers prefer new commercial versus new residential. If you're doing any work, plumbing work in industrial types of environments, or if you're working in hospitals or schools, anything of that type of nature, public works, that's something you need to let your agent know, because that could dictate the policy and dictate the premium. Now, smaller plumbing contractors, they're smaller program. Let's say, just for the sake of this video, you're doing under $500,000 a year in gross sales. You might have one or two employees, not really subcontracting much work, but because plumbers typically are the subs, general contractor, or you might work directly for the property owner. But in that case, those policies are typically based or rated on the payroll. Okay, so they use payroll as the determining factor. Policies can range anywhere from $2,500 to $5,000 a year for small plumbers. But if you start to get into the work I talked about before new residential multi-unit, you could be looking at a minimum premiums between $5,000 and $7,500, meaning that's going to be your starting point. Now, as you start to grow as a contractor, as a plumbing contractor, and you start to do more sales, we like to move those contractors into gross receipt-based programs. Keeps it cleaner. The rate is based on every $1,000 of gross sales. You don't have to worry as much about your payroll levels or any other factors in the policy. From $500,000 and up, you know, the sweet spot, $750,000 to a million in gross sales. Once you start getting above that, we really like to look at programs based on gross receipts for plumbing contractors. The rate can vary based on the type of projects you're involving in. I keep going back to that, but that's a huge, huge factor. And the forms that are in the policy, whether the policy is broad or not, or limiting, is going to determine your premium. In our book of business for plumbing contractors, range anywhere from $2,500. If you start to get less than that, you really got to wonder what type of policy you're buying, up to $50,000 or $75,000, depending on the size of the contractor. We have clients that are in plumbing that are big service and repair plumbers that have lots of trucks on the road that are going out and doing jobs, large employee base. So they're going to be paying more premium, obviously, because they have more exposure. That's kind of how it works. But again, the big takeaway here is no two policies are the same. That also goes for the additional insured endorsements that are on the policy. For bigger, larger plumbing contractors, especially if they're getting involved in commercial work, you know, you need to have specific endorsements. You need to have completed operations language. You need to make sure that the additional insured, whether it's an 1185 endorsement or CG 2010-2037. So all that stuff factors again. Is it automatic additional insured status? How many forms do you have on your policy? Do you have primary non-contributory wording? Do you have waiver of subrogation per project aggregate? All the stuff that you could start to see as a plumbing contractor once you start getting in larger contracts and start getting requirements from the people that you're doing work for. So again, very wide range here. I think the point is that price of the policies could really range significantly based on your exact operations, the type of work you're doing, the size of your business. And that's why you need to have a great agent or a great broker that understands the marketplace, that knows which carriers are available to help, and that can go out and secure coverage, secure proposals, and bring them back to the table and explain them to you so that you can make an informed decision on the policy that you think is best suited for your business. If you like our video, if they provide value, please throw us a thumbs up, hit that little notification bell, and subscribe to the channel so that any future videos that we release, you are made aware of. If you have any questions about this particular video, you can email us at hello@foagency.com or call 858-384-1506. Our brokers could help you. If you want to comment on the video, please do so. I reply to all comments and all questions, and any feedback you may have, we really appreciate. Thanks again for watching, and we will see you on another video very soon.